8. KFC Chicken. Kentucky Fried Chicken is an American fast food staple. The company's secret seasoning recipe was first developed during the 1940s by the restaurant's infamous founder, Colonel Harlan Sanders. He admitted to using salt and pepper as two of the ingredients, but never revealed the 9 other notorious herbs and spices in the mix, which he said are all found commonly in people's kitchens. Over 70 years after the first KFC opened up in Salt Lake City, Utah, the same recipe is still being used, and its ingredients have stayed a well-kept secret. The recipe is held in a vault that looks like an ordinary closet entrance at the company's headquarters located in Louisville, Kentucky. The safe has 2-foot-thick walls, is kept under 24/7 constant surveillance, and is even protected by armed guards. Only one person knows the safe's combination, and only 2 people know the 11 ingredients and their exact quantities. 2 different companies are given the coveted task of creating the mix, with each handling a different part of the recipe. The 2 components are then blended together through a computer processing system. 7. Coca-Cola. The original Coca-Cola recipe was created during the late 19th century by a man named John Pemberton. After he passed away in 1891, American businessman and Coca-Cola company founder Asa Candler purchased the rights to the recipe. Candler went out of his way to keep the formula secret. He also made several changes to the ingredients to improve the drink's overall taste, which meant that anyone in possession of Pemberton's original recipe did not have the actual Coca-Cola formula. In 1919, a group of investors led by businessman Ernest Woodruff bought the Coca-Cola company. Between then and 2011, for nearly 100 years, the recipe was kept hidden in vaults in New York City and Atlanta. Today, it's locked inside a safe at the World of Coca-Cola Museum in Atlanta, where the vault's giant door is put on display for the public. Over the years, many people have come forth claiming to have the recipe, but the Coca-Cola company insists no one has the authentic formula except them. The only people who know the recipe are a small handful of employees whose identities are kept hidden. As you probably know, the original Coca-Cola actually had cocaine in it. The narcotic was taken out of the recipe in 1903, but the company continues to use processed coca leaves that have the cocaine removed. This decocainized extract is manufactured by a New Jersey-based company, which has been processing the leaves for over a century. The U.S. government banned the import of coca leaves back in 2021, but the facility that processes the ingredient for Coca-Cola was specifically given an exception, and it remains the only American company with that privilege to this day. For this reason, it would be difficult for anyone in the U.S. to truly mimic genuine Coca-Cola, even if they had the right recipe. 6. Butterbeer. Butterbeer used to only exist in the world of Harry Potter books and in the imaginations of the series author and countless readers. It became a real thing, though, when the Wizarding World of Harry Potter officially opened at Universal Studios back in 2010. The beverage is also available at the Hollywood and Osaka, Japan locations. In 2007, Universal Orlando chef Steven Jason was given the task of developing the Butterbeer recipe, along with a few other food and drink items from the Harry Potter series. He had never actually read the Harry Potter books or seen the movie before, but he did his research and spent the next 3 years perfecting the Butterbeer recipe. After all that hard work, it received a final seal of approval from J.K. Rowling herself. The drink has since been described as having a rich and creamy taste, with noticeable butterscotch flavors and hints of similar sweet ingredients like vanilla and caramel. But only Jason and a few others know what's truly in it, and you can bet that the recipe is a closely guarded secret. Speaking with Bon Appetit in 2010, Steven said his goal was to create a concoction that was for everyone, with an unfamiliar yet soothing and smooth taste. Butterbeer was such a huge hit on the Wizarding World's opening day that staff members could hardly keep up with the demand for it. Jason later described seeing die-hard Harry Potter fans get emotional when trying the drink for the first time, with some even shedding tears after waiting 6 hours in line to get a taste. For those of you who have tried the Butterbeer at Universal, is it as magical as it sounds? Let us know in the comments below. 5. Krispy Kreme Glazed Donuts. The original Krispy Kreme's glazed donut goes back to the founder's great uncle, Ishmael Armstrong. According to the legends, Armstrong either purchased the recipe from a New Orleans chef named Joe LeBeau or was inspired by him to create it. He then passed the formula to his nephew, Plumy Rudolph, who gave it to his son, Varin Rudolph, in the 1930s. After his father and uncle's success with selling the donuts, Vernon Rudolph opened up his first Krispy Kreme store in 1937 in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. In 1973, just 3 years after Vernon's death, Beatrice Foods bought the Krispy Kreme name. The company altered the secret recipe to increase profits, but people noticed the donuts had lost their original unique taste. Less than a decade later, Beatrice Foods sold Krispy Kreme to longtime employee Joseph McAllier, who came up with the funding with help from several investors. McAllier went back to the original recipe, allowing the Krispy Kreme company to grow rapidly. Today, there are over 300 locations in multiple countries, including the UK, Peru, New Zealand, Colombia, and many more. The Krispy Kreme recipe is kept in a vault somewhere at the company's headquarters in Winston-Salem. Only a few trusted employees know where it is and have access to it. 4. Campari. Invented in 1860 in Novara, Italy, Campari is a liqueur famous for its distinct bittersweet flavor. It's the main ingredient for several classic cocktails, including the Negroni and the Garibaldi. Campari is also typically served on its own and in a before-dinner drink, or aperitif, which consists of soda water, prosecco, and sometimes bitters. In addition to its unique taste, Campari has a famously bright red color that was achieved through dye made from crushed-up insects, up until 2006 at least. The liquor consists of water, alcohol, sugar, and a mix of herbal extracts, including saffron and chinoto. Campari's taste is best described as complex. It has a noticeable orange flavor, as well as wood, floral, and herbal notes. During a visit to the company's main bottling plant in Sesto San Giovanni, a Saver journalist named William Serrell learned that the recipe also contains rhubarb and ginseng. But the bulk of Campari's recipe, which is rumored to have over 30 herbs, aromatic plants, and fruit, is a secret. According to Serrell, the only person in the world who knows the whole formula is the bottling plant's director, and great efforts are maintained to keep it that way. Some ingredients are even shipped to the director's office in discreet brown packaging to protect the recipe's secrecy. When asked what would happen if the director suddenly passed away, an employee said that there's a strategy in place for the recipe to be passed on to the right person. But the details of this emergency plan are strictly confidential. Assuming nothing like that ever happens, the next person to receive the Campari recipe will most likely be whoever becomes the next director. 3. Thomas's English Muffins. Thomas's is one of the most popular English muffin brands in the entire United States, with annual sales supposedly exceeding $500 million. Many of the company's employees are familiar with multiple parts of the recipe and the manufacturing process as a whole, but as of 2010, only 7 people in the world knew the entire recipe from start to finish. One of those 7 happened to be 56-year-old Chris Botticella, who was the vice president at Bimbo Bakeries USA when it acquired the Thomas's company. Curious about the secret behind the English muffins, Botticella embarked on a personal mission to find the recipe. He then left Bimbo with some of his coworkers under the impression that he was retiring. Chris actually took a job with rival company Hostess, which had previously tried and failed to obtain the secrets to Thomas's English muffins. Afraid that he was going to share the recipe with his new employers, Bimbo took the case to court. Lawsuit documents described how the English muffin formula had to be divided into multiple parts to preserve its secrecy. The information included not only the ingredients, but also the equipment and techniques used during the manufacturing process. Information is shared with employees on a need-to-know basis only. Bimbo's lawyers accused Chris of downloading several sensitive documents to his computer right before he left the company. He claimed he was simply practicing his computer skills for his new job. But a federal judge determined that he was planning to share trade secrets with Hostess and banned him from accepting the new position. Who knew muffins were so serious? 2. Bush's Baked Beans. the family-owned Bush Brothers & Company started out as a cannery in Chestnut Hill, Tennessee, during the early 20th century. When overproduction and low prices caused struggles for the canning industry in 1969, the company looked for other ways to diversify its income. Using a recipe created by the founder's daughter-in-law, Kathleen, they started manufacturing baked beans. Bush's had their work cut out for them, with big-name companies like Heinz and Campbell's dominating the industry at the time. They managed to give these well-known brands a major run for their money. Bush's baked beans became a huge success, and today the company produces about 80% of all the baked beans consumed in the United States. The family never expected the product to take off, so they didn't exactly have secrecy in mind when the first cans of beans hit shelves. But the savory mixture of flavorings that give the beans their unique taste quickly became their main selling point. During the 1990s, the company started focusing its advertising on a secret family recipe. Today, there are many measures in place to preserve the recipe's secrecy. The ingredients are obtained from several different suppliers to ensure that no single company knows the complete list. In the words of Bush spokesperson Mike Morris, "The company takes precautions, but I don't think there's a whole lot of international espionage out there to figure out how to make baked beans." A closely guarded copy of the family's recipe book is out on display at the Bush's Visitor Center in Tennessee, which is lovingly known for being the world's most beautiful bean museum. While a trip to the museum likely won't end with insider knowledge about the recipe, those who have been there say it's well worth a visit, and that it's surprisingly fun for a place that focuses on the history of baked beans. 1. Monk's Chartreuse. Known for its distinctive green, chartreuse is a French herbal liquor that dates back to the early 17th century. It's made by Carthusian monks at the Grand Chartreuse Monastery, located in the French Alps. These monks live in almost complete isolation from the rest of the world, and even from one another. They support their lifestyle largely through profits from the manufacturer of chartreuse, which means that if another version were to ever come along, it would potentially threaten their way of life that's been carried on for nearly 900 years. The monks started making the drink in 1737 based on a set of instructions given to them in 1605 by a French diplomat named François-Annabelle d'Estrées. Chartreuse comes in both green and yellow varieties. Its taste has been described as slightly sweet, spicy, and smooth with an almost botanical finish. Green chartreuse has flavors of lime, citrus spice, and fresh-cut herbs, while the yellow version contains notes of honey, saffron, and anise spice, giving it a much sweeter taste. The cheapest bottles sell for at least $40, while some of the rarest varieties go as high as $1,150. With proofs ranging from 80 to 138, chartreuse is strong. The recipe consists of 130 herbs and plants. Only two monks involved in its manufacture know or have access to the list. Other monks are familiar only with a few bits and pieces of the process. Secular employees act as the company's bridge to the rest of the world, handling the marketing, sale, and other aspects of business that would interfere with the monk's lifestyle. But the only outsider who knows the recipe for chartreuse is a New York City-based Catholic priest named Michael Hollerin, who learned it while watching the distilling process in the 1980s. In 2020, he told the New York Times that he never had to sign any sort of non-disclosure agreement, but that the secret will be safe with him. By keeping their cards close to their chest and staying separate from the outside world, the Carthusian monks have solidified their survival, both physically and financially, during times of crisis. When the COVID-19 pandemic hit, operations at the distillery went on as usual, as the monastery was safely untouched and far away from the virus. With no direct competition, sales stayed high. The monastery was even able to help out other struggling members of their industry, including manufacturers who fell short on supplies and bartenders who were out of work. Stories like this are a good reminder of how sometimes keeping a secret is a good idea. Thanks for watching. Which of these recipes do you want to know the most? If you enjoyed today's video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Bye for now.